Hi everybody, it's Bruce with Nature Calls, and today I'm making a ridgeline organizer for my daughter's hammock that I've been working on and doing all live for you. So of course ridgeline organizers are they're great, and I have multiple hammocks, so I'm just kind of sitting down making a ton. But this is a typical ridgeline organizer that I make. They're made out of the no-see-um bug netting, and you know, it's a great way, like if you've got some old tents that you're gonna throw away, to take their bug netting and keep it for projects just like this. So this hangs on to the ridgeline kind of above your head, and then it gives you a place to put things like headlamps or food or you know, any of those kind of things, cell phones. I actually put my carry weapon in there, so I just reach right up if I have to. And this is kind of what I've got to in the evolution. You don't have to make it. Hey, Ken. Hey, you don't have to make it this elaborate. I've made them actually pretty slim, pretty nothing. You know, you can just make them really as minimal, or I'd say this is about as exciting as you want to get. You don't want to get too much more than that. But this has it has three pockets on this side, and then it has two pockets on this side, which is great if you're outside of your hammock. I find that when I'm in my hammock, I don't want to be reaching up and around, so I just do the fold over, and so you've got this middle pocket to kind of put things in when you're laying down and reaching up. But yeah, so these are super simple to make. And last time I was hammocking in my hammock, I only had one short one, and I was thinking, well, I'd like to have like three of those. Yeah, that would be cool. You know, just I like to have things up and where I can see them. It helps you the whole time you're out. They're really easy and really to see what you've got going on. And then once it's out, it's organized, it's cool. So I've never made one out of like fabric you can't see through. I started making them with bug net, so that just seems to work well for me. So, and again, I'm not a master seamstress or anything like that, so some of the things that I do might not be phenomenal seamstress type stuff. So the one thing you need is I like to get like one big piece, and then I'll fold it over, and that becomes my hanging ridgeline thing. And so this is kind of a rectangle. Let me see if I like it the other way. Maybe the other way. Nope, that way is good. Okay, so let me measure this for you guys so you can see kind of what I'm working with. And you know, I just cut up some old bug netting. So this one is 22 and a half inches one way, and about 18 and a half inches the other way. So I'm gonna be folding it like the long way down, so it'll be 18 and a half inches wide. And you can kind of see where I didn't cut it perfectly straight. You'll be amazed at how much you can do kind of as you go along to make it look good. But the first thing to do, and this you have to kind of look at it in stages, and you have to do a bunch of things before you do something else. And what I found is the first thing I do is I'm gonna hem these two sides down and get those done. And I don't use pins or anything. I just fold it over and fold it again, so it's a double hem. So I'm just folding it once, about a quarter inch, and then folding it again, about a quarter inch. And then I will just use the sewing machine to actually do it. So this is live. I think I got this set up pretty well, so I can just adjust it down. So if you have any questions at all, please ask. This is just a standard Kenmore home machine. It does have the needles I use for making hammocks, which are Microtech needles, so they're really sharp. They aren't necessary for this project, but I do mostly ripstop type work, so I use the Microtech. This thread is also a polyester thread, which again isn't necessary for this project. It's necessary for like if you're doing hammocks. So I will set that down, and with this cool thing on this machine, and I think mainly a lot of machines do that, there's a button that will drop the needle down. And so now the needle's down, and now I've got something that's helping me hold the fabric or this netting, so I can kind of work and get it all set up. And let's do a run here. So you go forward a little bit and you back it up, and then that locks it. And then you just kind of cruise on through. Yeah, if you guys have a particular question or anything like that, go ahead and ask. I'll try and catch it. I'm looking kind of at either way. I'm trying to get my daughter to go out next week on a hammock hang with her new hammock. And I will most likely be using my new REI bridge. I'm not any kind of a seamstress or anything like that, so I fully encourage anybody that wants to make their own gear, especially things like this. This is really simple. And I'm not having to put any fancy settings or anything like that on my sewing machine for this project. I do that with my hammocks and things, but this one, I just turned it on and speed up a little, I guess. Turned it on, just kind of let the default settings work. I just kind of ripped through this stage. There's my scissors. So I am using the orange thread because that's what my daughter's hammock is being used, and I don't really care too much, but it'll go with her hammock. But you could use black thread, and that would definitely make it that much more something that's not seen. So, but the orange is kind of a nice detail. Come on, cut. I'm gonna flip you guys back up a little bit. So, get the other side. So, when you do things like hemming, make sure you're, you know, if you want them both going the same way, you make that decision at this point. So you don't have one hem going one way and one hem going the other way. So I will just kind of rip this side out. And another interesting thing is this netting is really stretchy, so it's a lot more stretchy. I don't use needles. I just kind of hold it tight as I go along. Hey, you Betsy Ross? Yeah. Hey, you'd be surprised, Ken. Ken saying I'm Betsy Ross. Once you get started with it, you learn pretty quick, and most of the stuff that I do, like hammocks and tarps, they're really, I think, pretty simple. You're not making anything, any kind of complicated corners or tucks or folds. I mean, you can if you want. Like say with a hammock, I almost think that if you could use a hot knife and do all your edges with a hot knife, that would actually be the optimal way of doing it. Especially if you're a gram counter, you could get rid of all the thread and it would work great. That's what ripstop is. Okay. All right. So here we go. So now we've got the two sides hemmed up, and so that's the way it will go like that. So the next step, and they're all steps, is on your pockets. You have to do something similar. So on the very top of the pocket where you stick your hand in, I'm going to do a little fold over hem. And let's get this going. Drop that needle down a little bit. Now let me see it. Now when you are sewing, I'll try and, so to start, you go forward a little bit, and then you go backwards a little bit, and that locks in your first set, and so you don't, it won't go come undone on you. Anybody else getting out these days? I haven't done a hammock in a few weeks. When I did a tent camp out last week over in Eastern Washington, which was just fantastic. We have a lot of really cool geological areas over here. We don't have any battle sites or anything like that. But we have really cool geological zones. And I don't know if you can tell how much, if I was going to stop and pin all this stuff, it'd take me forever. I just don't have necessarily the patience for all that. That is one thing when you're doing this stuff. Actually, if you can have some patience, things do come out a ton better. Okay, there's one side, but this is this live thing, and I don't want everybody to get super bored. So I'm not taking as much patience as I would normally. I just kind of want this to, be entertaining as well as informational. So I'm just doing the other side right now, the other pocket. Locking it and getting everything all set up. Where's everybody from out there? And up here in Seattle land, it's been, can't count on anything other than it's going to rain one day and it'll be sunny the next. It's kind of what our weather is doing right now. And even though I'm all equipped to go out in pretty much any kind of weather, I don't necessarily like to go out in torrential rain. Not that much of a lover of rain. But I also don't necessarily like having to clean all my gear so much after it rains. you really get a... Oh, okay, well this is a good situation here. What happened is my bobbin ran out on me. I should have been looking. It would have been really easy for me to look because it was mesh. But so my bobbin's run out, and so it's no big deal. So I just have to redo my bobbin, and kind of show how that happens. So I'm going to take my bobbin out, and that's the thread that's on the bottom. And it's going to take my thread out of this, and then find a little hole, and you put it up through the little hole, and you put it over here on the bobbin winder, lock it in, and there's a tension right there, and that holds tension on it, and we'll start it up a little bit. I'm just holding onto this thread over here. once it gets a few turns on it, then you can cut that off. Now we'll just wind that bobbin up. Pretty trick. Now one thing I do is, as soon as there's a little automatic stop system over here, and right when it gets to that, I shut it down. When I do like regular clothes, that doesn't seem to be as big a deal, but when I'm working with, say, sil nylon or any kind of ripstop nylon, if I pack the bobbin too much, then I'll have problems later. Okay, so the bobbin's full. Let's take it off and cut it. And then I put the bobbin back into the little hole. And everybody's sewing machine is probably a little bit different. I have to put it in a certain way over here. And there's little hooks. And now the bobbin's set, but now I've got to re-thread my whole machine. Let me see if I can bring it over here. Sorry. This way you guys can kind of see what I go through. So there's my sewing machine. Here's my thread up here on the top. And there's little arrows to help me know what to do. But the first thing I do is put it through right here. And that's got a tension spring. And it goes down this crack underneath it, back up, through this little hook right there, back down through the crack. Then the hard part, because I have the bad vision, is to thread it through the needle. I've kind of just learned to kind of go for a certain area. And hopefully, stick your tongue out a little bit. Come on. It doesn't work the first time. I just go ahead and cut it and get a new end on it. Lick it. Come on. You guys see it better than me? Come on. Sometimes okay, there we go. It's probably the hardest part about all this. And there's another little hook right up inside there. Go underneath your foot, and you hold on to your top thread, cycle it through, and that goes down and catches the bottom thread, and you just pull it up through. I grab my little seam ripper and pull that thread through. That's it. So I am good to go again. Let me get you guys back out here. My little bobbin cover back on. Now I'll find my my piece that I ran out of thread on. I just kind of start right back where I were, back where I was, about like a half inch. And the only thing I'm gonna have to do is do a lock stitch right at that point. And then I continue on. Okay, here we go. So, everybody back up here. All right, so now, let me clean this up a little bit. Easier to clean up your extra threads as you go along than trying to have to go back and find them, in my opinion. So now what we need to do, and you gotta kind of think this through a lot. So that's the way it's gonna be. And then the pocket's going to go right there. But what we're gonna do now is sew the pocket on, and I'm just gonna fold it over one time and attach it to the big outer pocket. Does that make sense? So here's the outer pocket, and I'm making sure where the hem is. And then here's the big outer part. So this is gonna go on right there. Right now I'm going to, I'm just going to attach it on this side and on the other side. That's all I'm gonna do right now. Some cleanup to do. Alrighty. And you just have to line up the bottom of the pocket with the bottom of the big pocket. And that will give you the right amount, but you don't have to be super exact. And you'll see why in a bit. Let's get that up there better. Because you're going to be folding and hemming things again. And that'll all get covered up. All right, so down we go. Drop the needle and line everything up. Very good, okay. Forward, lock it, rip. Lock it. Done with that side. And now I'll do the other side. And this is, so here, let's take a quick look at this. So I may have not cut things perfect when I was cutting it. So see right here where it's like way longer. So I can trim it right now. And that's not a big deal at all. I'll just kind of trim it on down. Very good. Now I will fold that over, single hem, and we'll tack that side down. Anybody out making hammocks right now out there in the interweb? Do the other side, and we are getting closer. Not that I'm an anti-pin person. In fact, this might actually be a little more helpful with pins. I just don't use a lot of pins when I'm doing working with sil nylon, just because I don't like to keep putting holes in my sil nylon. That looks good. Get over there and the sil nylon, you don't want to have a lot of holes in it in the first place, because if you do, you're going to end up having to seam seal everything a lot more. Plus, it just doesn't like to have holes in it. It is ripstop, but it doesn't like to have holes in it. Okay, so is that one looking any better? All right, that one's a little bit better, so I'll just go ahead and fold it over. Come on. Very good. I gotta concentrate. What do you guys think of this live stuff? Is it worth it? I guess it gets recorded. All right. I got a thumbs up on that one. Sweet. Okay, so now both pockets are on. We do some cleanup work. So both pockets are on, and so now, like with this one here, I decided to put three pockets on one side and two pockets on the other side. So I'll kind of do that again. This is at the time you want to do that. So let's just kind of pick a spot in the middle. You could measure this all out, and I know there's, you know, some people that do that. This is just for me or my family, and I have a lot of people that hang, so I have to make a lot of this stuff, and it's really more of a, I need to kind of do them quickly usually, and so I don't, if I was going to make this as a company, yeah, I would take a lot more time and you know, make them look really pretty. But it's not. And if my kids have a problem, they can make it themselves. Okay, so that one has two pockets. And on this one, this side, we're going to do the three pocket thing. A little cleanup work. All right, so let me drop you guys down so you can kind of see what I'm up to. Okay, so we're gonna make one right there. Go backwards first. So that's how you do a pocket. Cut those, clean up. And we're about halfway through now. We're definitely done with the kind of the hard part. You can kind of see, kind of, it's not that straight. You'll see something really cool here in a minute. Get this pocket, this side done. Okay. So now we got all the pockets done. Okay, so now we've got the pockets sewn on. Come on. Now we have the pockets sewn on, the hemming on the sides. So now what we need to do is, that's kind of wonky. So now we're going to put them face to face. So the pocket side is going to go face to face. Like that, because we're going to turn them inside out here in a minute. Now here's where I can really make up for this ragged edge, and I can sew right down that And then I can cut it off. Here, I'll just kind of make sure everything's looking nice. I got some kind of weird edges on there, but it's all right. So that's... And I found you don't want the pockets too deep. So yeah, I'm doing down here. So now, let's do a little cleanup. All right, so here. So now I've got this kind of really wonky edge here. So all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cut with my scissors and get rid of all that. Then I'm cutting about maybe a little more than an eighth of an inch away from that last thing I sewed. So now I've got the real clean edge on it. Okay, so now it's all inside out. So now all we do is invert it. Voila. All nice again. Because now we got the pockets on the outside. I could have done that one a lot better. But here we've got it all hemmed up. Now we have one last step to do. And what I do is I sew right across here. And that's where your ridge line will go through. And that I found, you don't want that huge, you want it big enough so it's easy to thread your ridge line through, maybe a half inch or 3/4 of an inch. Okay, let me get right down here. Okay, so I'm going to, and you can find little marks on your sewing machine usually that will help you guide. Kind of go ahead and guide right on that. But if you make it too, if you don't do this, I found it, your little bag will rotate a lot, and it's kind of a pain. And this just kind of holds it and keeps it from folding up on itself. It really does a lot to have that ridge line slot up there. So now we have right up here, put your ridge line through this top piece, and it really helps. Okay, so there we go. There is a ridge line organizer, simple, fast, kind of crazy, doing it on this live thing, but super simple. That probably took me, with talking, what, about a half hour? So there you go. This one definitely looks a lot better. I did this one the other day. But I'm not that picky of a person when it comes to my own gear. But here you can see it's got a place where you can put a lot of stuff inside this part. And this part here I use for like my pistol and my headlamp. Out here is where things I'm not going to need in the middle of the night when I'm sleeping. Cell phones, maps or whatever go fine out there, but when you're laying down to kind of reach up and over, it's kind of a pain for me. So right here is where I do a lot. Oh, and actually here, what I did, I'll show you that little trick. Right here I've sewn up about an inch, so if something goes in here, it's got something to catch it. So let's go ahead and we'll do that as well on this one, because that really helps. So I'm just gonna go up about an inch from the bottom. Now it's going through a lot more. That helps keep things in that pocket and not falling out. It's like you definitely don't want your gun falling out on hitting in the head. And then on the other side as well. There we go. So now they have that little kind of a catch. I'll show you that again here in a second so you can kind of see what I'm talking about again. So, gotta bring it back up. So here it's hanging from your ridge line and you put something in here, right here at the end. I've sewn it up just a little bit so things won't fall out. So. There you go. It's just a design, just an idea. The key is, you know, they're super easy. They're super fun to play with, and I think anybody can do this stuff. Don't get too hung up. Have a good time. Decide what you need, say in a Ridgeline organizer, and make it. It's a lot of fun. So, all right. Well, thanks a lot. Thanks everybody for hanging out with me, and I'll see you out on the trail. Bye now.